Hi students, in this class we will see what are algorithms and what is the complexity of an algorithm. First we will see what are algorithms. An algorithm is a set of steps for solving a particular problem. So before writing a program, we have to write the steps in a sequential order. And then it is converted into a program. The main characteristics of an algorithm are, first one is, each step should be simple and precise. The steps in an algorithm should be simple and precise, that is, small steps. Each step should be finite, that is, it should be carried out in a particular time. So there is a limit to the time taken for executing a particular step. An algorithm can accept zero or more inputs. Then it should produce the desired output. These are the characteristics of an algorithm. Now, the different approaches to design an algorithm. A complex algorithm can be divided into smaller units called modules. And this process of dividing an algorithm into modules is called modularization. So, if the algorithm is complex, we can divide it into small parts or units called modules, and the process of dividing an algorithm into smaller units is called modularization. The main advantages of modularization are, the complex algorithm can be made simple to design and implement. That is, if we write small modules, then we can combine it to produce the complex algorithm. So, it is easy to write simple task first. And the second advantage is testing and debugging is easier. That means if we have a complex algorithm, it is difficult for us to find the errors in the algorithm. But if the program is divided or the algorithm is divided into different modules, we can find out which module contains an error, and it is easy to correct that. Debugging means correcting errors. And there are two ways to design an algorithm. First one is top-down approach and the second one is bottom-up approach. In top-down approach, the complex algorithm is divided into one or more modules. These modules are further divided into sub-modules, and this process is continued until the desired level is reached. This process is done from top to bottom. That is, a complex algorithm is divided into a number of modules, then it is divided again until a specified level is reached. And the processing is done from top to bottom. This is the diagram for that. That is, this is the main module. It is divided into module 2 and module 3. Module 2 is again divided into module 4 and 5. And module 3 is divided into module 6. So, the main module is divided into a number of sub-modules. And the processing starts from top to bottom. This is called top-down approach. Next one is, we have the bottom-up approach. Here also, we divide the algorithm, complex algorithm, into a number of modules. And this is the reverse process of top-down approach. Here, but we design the basic modules first. Then, these sub-modules are grouped together to form a higher level module. And the higher level modules are again grouped, and this process is repeated until the complete algorithm is obtained. That is, in the case of bottom-up approach, we divide the complex algorithm into a number of modules, into a number of levels. And the designing starts from the sub-modules. The sub-module will be designed first, then it will be combined to form the higher level module, then it is combined to form the complex algorithm. So, here also the modules are divided into a number of sub-modules, and the processing starts from bottom to top. That is, module 4 and module 5 are designed first. These two are combined to form module 2. And module 6 is combined to form module 3. And 2 and 3 are combined to form module 1. This is bottom-up approach. So, there are two ways to design an algorithm: bottom-up approach and top-down approach. Now we will see the complexity of an algorithm, that is the time-space trade-off. The complexity or the efficiency of an algorithm depends on two measures, that is time and space. The complexity of an algorithm is represented as a function f of n, which measures the time and or the space required by an algorithm in terms of the input size n. That means if we have 10 elements to be processed, the time taken for processing these 10 elements and the space needed to store these elements. These two factors determine the complexity or the efficiency of an algorithm. Time complexity means the time taken to run a program, which is expressed as a function of input size. When the input size increases, automatically the time taken for execution will also increase. And space complexity means the amount of computer memory required during program execution, expressed as function of input size. So, time complexity means the amount of time taken for execution, which all depends on the input size. And space complexity means the amount of computer memory required, that is also expressed as a function of input size. An efficient algorithm should take less amount of space and time. We know that we can write a program using different logic. So, some algorithms or programs will take less time and some may take more time. Both will be doing the same function. And if the number of variables used are less, the memory space also will be less. So, an efficient algorithm should take less amount of space and time. Then we can express the time complexity in three ways. First one is the worst case running time. From the term itself, we know that it is the worst one. That is the maximum time taken by an algorithm. This is the maximum time. For a searching algorithm, here we are taking the example of a searching algorithm. If the item to be searched is the last element in an array, then it is called the worst case. Suppose we have 10 elements in an array and the element to be searched is stored at the last location, and we are using a linear search method. That is, we have to search the elements one by one. So, first element will be searched. Suppose we have to search the element 10. So, 10 will be compared with the first element, then second element, third element, etc. And if 10 is present at the last location, then we have to search the full array. So, it takes more time. That is, the element to be searched is the last element in the array. And this is the worst case for a searching algorithm. And search reaches the upper bound of the array. That is A of 9 means the 10th element will be the element that we are searching for. Next one is best case running time. From the name itself, we know that the time taken will be very less. That is, it is the shortest time taken for searching. In that case, the element to be searched will be the first element in the array. If the element that we are searching is the first element, then we have to compare only one time. That is, the element to be searched and the first element will be compared. And the first position itself, we have that element. So, searching will be stopped there. So, the time taken will be the shortest time. And search takes the lower bound. And the third one is average case running time. It is the running time for an average input. That means the element may be around the middle of the array. In best case, the element will be in the first position. In the worst case, the element will be in the last position. And in the average case, the element may be in between these two values, around the middle of the array. So, the number of comparisons can be 1, 2, etc., 3, etc., n. You do not know where the element is present. So, the probability P can be represented as P is equal to 1 by n. So, the complexity of n can be represented using the formula 1 into 1 by n plus 2 into 1 by n plus etc. n into 1 by n. That is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3, etc. into 1 by n. That is n into n plus 1 by 2 into 1 by n. That is n plus 1 by 2. So, the average case running time can be represented as n plus 1 by 2. So, when we calculate the complexity of a searching algorithm, the average case will be n plus 1 by 2, where n is the number of elements in an array. So, we have three cases, and the worst running time, the average running time, and the best running time. And the complexity of an algorithm is measured using two terms, that is the space and time. A good algorithm will take less time and less space. That is an efficient algorithm. Thank you.